This right here is the exact weather that every time I consider going solar, which I've done a few times, I just think, you know what? Because of the months of this weather we get, it's just not worth it. But when you think about it, I know it's daytime right now because it's bright out. Theoretically, if the light is getting to me and my eyes for me to know it's daytime, there should be light getting to my panels to charge my batteries. And it's a pretty common myth that if you live somewhere where it's cloudy a lot of the time, that going solar is just a bad investment because you won't actually be able to generate your own power. But contradictory to that, I've been getting a ton of ads lately to go solar and showing homes in the snow in the winter, which honestly just leaves me with a lot of questions. So today, we're putting this myth to the test.
So we started this test with two 100 watt solar panels. And on a good day, these panels both produce really close to their 100 watt rating. For anybody that doesn't know, solar panels don't actually produce 100 watts if they're a 100 watt panel. They could, but it's very, very rare. When they make a solar panel, they have what's called a STC, which is a standard testing condition. It's almost impossible to recreate. And it basically just says that, you know, the panel will produce 100 watts when it's at a perfect angle, when the temperature of the cell is at the right temperature, which even if it's cold out, the cell can heat up because it's a dark color. There's all kinds of stuff that goes into this, but basically whatever your panel's rated for, very rarely will you ever actually get that. When I go camping and overlanding, I use two 100 watt Jackery panels, and if they generate 180 watts, I'm happy. That's pretty good. So keep that little bit of information in mind for this test. And so I plugged two of these 100 watt panels directly into two identical Delta Pro units, and we got nothing.
This very, very dead Delta Pro knows it's connected. We got our little logo there, but we're not seeing any input.
Which I actually love because this is a really realistic situation. So I went back to the drawing board and I found two more 200 watt rich solar panels in the garage. And as soon as I swapped those panels over, we found some instant success.
Hey, good news.
And basically what's happening here, and I'm actually really glad this happened because this is a real life scenario. In layman's terms, when solar panels are put outside in the sun, they generate electricity. And when it's not getting a lot of sun, they don't generate a lot of electricity. A Delta Pro unit needs 11 volts before it will register any input. And so these 100 watt panels actually have an 18 volt max. Because they were barely getting any sun, they weren't even close to hitting their 18 volts. They probably weren't over 11 volts. Now, if you have a whole array on your roof, you probably won't run into this because all those panels combined will definitely exceed the minimum voltage. So you will be seeing input. Because the 200 watt panels are a much bigger panel, they have much more surface area. They were able to produce over the 11 volts needed for the Delta Pro to even register that it was plugged in. And because we crossed that threshold, we started seeing some instant results. And so we were set. I had everything running. I even plugged one 100 watt foldable solar panel into the Jackery Explorer 1000 Plus, just as a second baseline to see what would happen. And we left them out in the sun for about an hour just to let them rip. And I went out and checked on them every 10 minutes or so. And we actually got super consistent results. We were seeing about 40 to 47 watts of input on both Delta Pro units almost every time I checked. And we were seeing about 22 watts of input into the Jackery almost every time I checked. More actually than I expected to be getting on a thick cloudy day. You would get way more than this in just like a October, fall, spring cloud. Here in the winter outside, it's just like a thick layer of just depression in the sky. It's not even a cloud. It's just the atmosphere is gray. And so these were pretty good results considering that. And like I told you guys, seeing 90% of the rated input is like perfect. So seeing 20% of a rated input's actually not bad. Yes, solar panels do work on cloudy days. But also you can't fail to remember that it's winter when I did this test. And so in the winter, the sun is at a much lower angle. So we ran this test again today actually, and we found some really interesting results. Today was a perfect blue sky day. And at the middle of the day, we saw about 120 watts out of a 200 watt panel. I had a 200 watt panel plugged into the Delta Pro, same situation. This time it was at a little bit more of an angle. I had it propped up against the outside of the house just to try and capture a bit more light. And we were seeing about 150 watts. And I did this test with multiple units with multiple panels, and we got very consistent and similar results. If I take that panel that was up against the house and laid it back down, we got about 120 watts. And what's interesting here is that that is strictly due to the angle of the sun because of the time of year. And usually the time of year and the cloudiness kind of coincide. So I think this is a really good example of it's winter and it's cloudy. That's when most people experience their cloudy weather. But because of that, you have to attribute some of that sun angle to the loss of power in the clouds. So if you take into account that we got about 120 watts today from a 200 watt panel into our Anker, which is at the same angle as we were testing out the other day, 120 watts, the other day we were seeing about 47. In the middle of summer, I see about 180 or 185. So what I'm trying to say is the sun being on an angle kills a bunch of input. And it's actually pretty impressive that we were still getting just under 50 watts of input on cloudy days. So yes, you do generate sun even through the clouds, which is really good to know. No, it's not nearly enough or as much as you would want it to be, but I would like to run this test again in like a really snowy day. I would like to run this test in a couple other conditions. Let me know if there's other tests that you guys would like to see, whether they're in a certain condition or they're just solar panel tests or generator tests or anything fun like this. I kind of like doing these little experiments. So let me know if there's anything else that you guys would like to see. And like always, make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel so you do not miss any of our new content. I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.